Howling Bells, welcome.
Hello.
It's good to see you. As I say, it's taken a while to get here. Let's do the introductions from left to right. We've got Joel Steen or Stein?
Whichever you prefer.
Well, no, it's your name.
Well, I don't mind.
Right. I think I'll call you Stein.
That's great.
Okay, right. Yeah. And Joel Stein. And on the other side, your sister Juanita. I might call you Juanita Steen.
I like that, Mark. It's very sexy.
Okay. All right. Fair enough, then. Right. I was going to go left to right. Sorry, that was very rude of me. I start off with Joel Stein, and then...
Now, hold on. You don't have to say it like that.
Right. Why not?
Stein.
You said I could say it how I want, and didn't he? Juanita, didn't he? He said, say it how you like.
He did say that.
I've changed my mind.
Honestly, right. We've got, Joel on guitar.
Thank you.
Right, and then we've got Glenn Moule on drums. Is it Moule, as in Marinier?
You can say it however you want.
Oh, yeah. Glenn Moulet.
That's the one, French.
Okay, right, okay then.
Don't even try my last name.
Brendan Picchio.
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 I've had it my whole life. It's
on the bass. What have you done for your arm? You got a big bandage on there.
Oh, it's just from loading gear incessantly.
Surely a band of the Howling Bells standing don't have to load their own gear in.
Let's not go there.
That's the question.
Let's not go there. But I'm a wimp, so it's...
Oh, right, fair enough then. And Juanita Stein.
Si, senor.
on the right here, on vocals and guitar. So, I mean, you've come from Brighton to see us then. It's busy, 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 isn't it?
It's busy, busy, busy. It never ends. We drove from Brighton yesterday. We finished the last date of our own tour. And then tomorrow we fly to Germany to start... touring with the Killers.
The Killers, right. Do you know them? Have you met them yet?
Never.
Right, okay then. I don't know. They strike me as a band that might be kind of... I know they're really good and really popular. Yeah. Strike me as that singer...
Yes.
Looks like he might be the kind of guy who kind of takes himself a bit seriously. I could be wrong.
You could be wrong, but you could be right.
Bass player, very tall.
Well, you were wrong about my surname.
I was right about your surname. I think you'll find, if you go back through the European origins of your name, Joel Steen, I think you'll find...
Radcliffe?
If you think from the Rammstein area...
Let's not make this a slingy match, come
right,
on.
Right, okay.
You had curry too, didn't you?
I did. It was it was a small bowl of... And anyway, I've washed it down with some...
my guitar's changing colour.
With Nyrelex Boots Dry Cough Relief Linctus.
Wow. Now, how much money do you get to say that on radio?
None, actually.
Oh, that's terrible.
I'll tell you what, though. It's two for one. I mean, you know, so I'm pleased with the bargain I've struck already today. I'll leave that there.
Howling Bells,
you see. There's no the.
No.
No. Right, okay. Then. And then you're off on tour with Futureheads.
Yes.
All right, you're coming back. You're doing Killers in Europe and then back here for Futureheads
and
tour.
And then, Mark.
Yeah.
And then back to Europe to tour with Placebo.
Now, you know the lead singer in Placebo, Brian Molko.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, he's a man who looks like trouble.
But he doesn't
the loveliest man in the world.
He's the coolest dude you'll ever meet.
They are the nicest people.
Yeah.
They are, right. And I think they may have the greatest difference in height between the front two. Apart from maybe the Manic Street Preachers.
Yeah, right.
Okay, you know, but I mean, Brian Moak, I mean...
He's about my height.
He's smaller than you. You're a petite gamine sort of person.
He's about my height.
But he's lovely people. Really, you'll have a great time with Placebo. We'll send them our regards.
Thank you.
I will.
Anyway, listen, great to have you. Whatever your names are. Thanks very much for coming.
Thanks, Mark.
Don't try and ingratiate now, Joel. I've fallen out with you.
I'm just talking
to the other three.
You've just had curry.
It was a long time ago.
A bit crazy.
You're trouble. I'm going to hide my cough syrup. I'm sure you've got it right now. Let's have a tune. What are you going to do for us first?
We're going to play a song for you called The Night Is Young.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. When I needed you to stay, drove your car the other way. Yeah.
Where'd that organ come from?
Can't you see the little man behind Glenn?
Oh, yeah, there he is.
We should have spoken.
Fantastic, fantastic. Howling Bells live in session. And that was The Night Is Young. We've got two more tunes to come during the course of the programme. Okay, Howling Bells are back with us. See, got that right that time at least. Juanita, Joel and Brendan and Glenn. Obviously from Australia originally, but you've been over here a while, haven't you now?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Right.
Living
here?
Are our mics on?
Yes, they are, yes. Hello.
2 years.
Yeah, right. So what brought you over here? Let's do the history for people who don't know the Howling Bells story. Right, and I'm allowed to say the Howling Bells story.
Well, that makes sense.
That's okay.
That's plural.
You were kind of vaguely all, at different times, another band. Is that right, called Waikiki?
We were vaguely another band at another time. And
But that band did pretty well, didn't it, in Australia?
It was relatively, it did okay.
Yeah.
And
was that a different sort of sound? Because, excuse my ignorance, I don't have any Waikiki records.
Well, you just need Howling Bells records.
Yes, well, I'm happy with Howling Bells record. But Waikiki doesn't sound like a kind
Howling
of alternative
Bells.
Name for Howling Bells, does
Howling
it?
Bells. Was it?
Do you not want to talk about it? Are you faintly embarrassed about Waikiki, you know?
I can talk about a band I was in before that as well.
Yeah, right, what was that?
What were we called? I can't remember.
That was a garage band.
It was some garage band.
It was just like another band we were in, and you know, happy, and then you kind of, as an artist, you get creatively, you become impatient with what you're doing, and you grow, and you get older, and you have new experiences, and it was really as simple as that. We started the band quite young.
Yeah.
So you turn, you know, maybe a few years later.
The lineup was different too, so.
Was it a sort of poppier band? I mean, a straight pop band?
Did you
have hits in Australia?
No. We weren't that poppy or successful. It was probably a bit more naive.
Right. And you started writing the songs that became the sound of Howling Bells.
That's right.
Right? And you changed the name. I always hesitate to ask, it seems such a dull question.
Mm-hmm.
And in that respect, not entirely different to all my other questions. But, I mean, the name of a band, the origin of it, it is a dull question. But Howling Bells is an intriguing one.
Joel?
Yes, well, you see, I was smoking my pipe one morning, staring at the sea, and it just came to me.
Right, did it?
Yes.
Okay. Do you still have that pipe for creative? For that,
that actually, can't you tell?
Customs took it.
Right, okay.
It was a magic pipe.
There, you see. I knew it was pointless asking, really. And I don't blame you. You treated with the disdain you deserve.
We're just tired.
It's all right, yeah. And so what brought you over here? How come you're living over here?
We recorded our album with Ken Nelson, and he lives in Liverpool.
Right.
And it seemed like the right direction to head in at the time.
Mm.
And we didn't have a definite date, so we kind of just moved with our intuition and kind of followed it all the way over the Merry Seas and landed in England and waited quite a while to record the album.
Yeah.
And that built up all the angst and passion that you hear on the record today.
And you were living with, is it right, you were all sort of living in... In one room, literally.
You've done your research.
Yeah. Well, a bit.
Yeah.
You know, I've been out shopping for cufflinks, so I haven't had that much time to spend on it, obviously. But was that right? You were all
it's
in one room?
It's perfectly right,
That's true, yeah.
Is it? Right.
But actually, there were five people in one small bedroom in East London.
Right.
West.
I don't know.
Yeah.
And how's
that as the only girl in the organisation?
There was one other girl.
Oh, there was one other. All right. So yes.
Yeah.
Sleep texter.
But we got hungry and we killed her and ate her.
Right, okay.
It was pretty unhealthy.
Yeah. Right, okay, let's have another tune. What are you going to do? Oh, we need to think of a question. We'll do that later, shall we?
Okay, we'll do it later.
We've got copies of the album to give away, obviously.
Cool. Well, here's a track off our album called A Ballad for the Bleeding Hearts.
Oh, right, lovely, thank you.
One, two, three. And I will wait for around, and I will scream just to get you hold me down. Tried all I could, told you to move, buried our heart in our hands, told me a lie, turn a blind eye.
So the Ballad for the Bleeding Hearts from the album, and we'll give away copies of that a bit later on. And you're Tom Waits fans, aren't you? We're talking about that. You're big fans of Tom Waits.
Yes,
yeah, okay.
Definitely.
Because I've got this, and I've barely got to grips with this yet, because his new album is a triple album.
It looks epic.
56 tracks, 30 new recordings, and a big book. But the book has sort of got adrift from mine, so I'm not sure of where all these tracks come from. And but I thought, before I spend the weekend trawling through it, we should at least have a blast of the first track. What do you reckon?
I'm excited.
Okay. So it's called Orphans, Brawlers, Ballers and Bastards, and each album sort of has a different kind of texture and atmosphere. Bastards is really interesting. So I was listening to it, for several hours last night, actually. Perplexing and intoxicating in equal measure, as you would expect. But I think we'll have a fairly straight ahead blast of, as straight ahead as Tom Waits gets these days, blast of rock and roll from the first album, Brawlers, and This Is Lie to Me. Okay, Howling Bells are with us. We'll get the question out of the way first, shall we? Did we decide on a question, or have you changed mind again?
Haven't changed my mind.
Okay. Has anybody else changed your mind? Anybody else changed their mind?
I'm sure Joel has.
Joel.
At least five times.
Is he? Are you the taciturn and sort of changeable one in the group then, Joel? You
yes.
keep changing your mind?
Yes. We'll answer for him.
No. Yes.
Yes.
No. Maybe.
Yeah, and a lot is talked about brothers in bands and things, and sibling rivalry. How does brother and sister in band work? Is it relatively harmonious or...?
Yes.
It works.
Does it?
It just works.
Really?
Yeah.
Were you kind of harmonious as kids? I mean, you didn't squabble
no.
as children. No. But it's just kind of evened out as...
Yeah, in no, it worked. I mean, we come from a very, very musical family. So Joel has a twin brother, Ari, and we all used to play music and make music growing up. So it's a fairly natural progression for us to have started a band.
Okay, good. Yeah. Right, yeah. And does it keep you on the straight and narrow? Do you keep him on a short sort of tether? I mean, does he not misbehave with his sister about, or vice versa? Do you not misbehave with him about? Is he your big brother?
I'm an arsehole.
Are you?
Yeah.
It's very candid of you, Joel. I think you're being unnecessarily harsh on you.
I'm honest.
Yeah. Right. Is he?
I'm just glad he didn't say the F word.
All right, okay. So we've got off lightly, have we?
Yep.
Well, perhaps we'd better move into competition time on Radio 2. Right, go on then. The question, Juanita.
Well, I mean, the most creative question I could come up with is which lovely rock star is roughly the same height as I am.
Right. Not any rock star, just who was mentioned earlier.
Mm. We were talking about him. He's very pretty.
Right, yeah, okay then. So which rock star we were talking about earlier is virtually the same height as Juanita. Right, and so mark.radcliffe@bbc.co.uk and 88 to 91 on the text. Right, we'll have last tune live. When are you actually back over here? Because as you say, you're going to Germany tomorrow, I think, aren't you, to hook up with Killers?
Yeah.
Right.
We're playing.
And then
we're playing some shows with the Future Heads.
Yeah, I'm just trying to look
at the Astoria.
Preston, is it 25th of November? Is that the first date you are back here? Do you think?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Preston and Glasgow on the 26th.
Yeah.
And Sheffield Leadmill on the 27th.
All the details are on our website.
All right. That's probably the best bet, isn't it? Really. Yeah. Okay. All right. Good. What are you going to do for the last tune?
We're going to play you our current single, Setting Sun.
A work of genius.
Ah. Shucks.
Oh,
Fantastic. Thanks ever so much. Thanks for coming to see us on your
thank you.
Schedule. Thanks for having us.
No, it's great to see you. Right. So you catch them on tour with Placebo or Future Heads or Killers if you're knocking about in Europe. Okay. And